we're going to look at Judges chapter 3. When I first read Judges 3 to prepare for this devotion, my first thought was, how will I talk about this? It's a war story, and to be honest, I don't like war stories. In this chapter, God raises up three different men to lead his people into battle and defeat their enemies. So in Judges 3, we could learn about being God's leader. But how does this story apply to my life if I don't see myself as someone leading an army in battle? One thing I love about God's Word is that each story has many things that we can learn from it. When I sit down to read the Bible, I try to remind myself of these two Bible study principles. The first is that the purpose of Bible study is for us to get to know God better. He's the God who wants to be known, and His desire is to have a relationship with each of us. So each time I hear or read the Bible, it's as if God is speaking to me so that I can know Him better. And secondly, He gave us His Word to change us. The Bible is the primary way that God communicates with us. It's not a book to merely read or even think about. I need to respond to what I read. James 1:22 says, "Be doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving yourselves." So what is God telling us about Himself in Judges 3? In these 30 verses, we see the Lord's name 15 times. Obviously, He's the main character of this story. In verses 1 to 4, we're told that the Lord left pagan nations in the land that He promised to give to His people, and He did that because He wanted to test them. It says that God wanted to teach warfare to the generations of Israelites who had no experience in battle. Also, the Lord wanted to see if this generation would obey the commands that were given to their ancestors through Moses. Why did God allow the enemy to remain living in their land? To God, He said it was important that His children learned warfare, or how to fight the enemy. He wanted them not just to know about His victory in the past, He wanted them to personally experience His power and see His victory in their own lives. He also left the enemy there to find out if His people would choose to obey Him or if they'd choose the lifestyle of the enemy. So what does this have to do with my life? We're all aware that our home here on earth is enemy territory. God is the ultimate ruler over all mankind, but He has left the enemy here. God gives each of us a choice. Do we want to live the way the enemy does, or do we want to live in obedience to Him? We may be deceived into thinking that the lifestyle of the world is not so bad, but in the areas of our life where we choose not to obey God, our enemy Satan is happy to gain a foothold into our lives. We each need to learn how to fight the enemy, because God wants us to personally experience His power and victory. And we need to learn to choose God's ways over the world's ways. The story of the Israelites showed us that many times they chose not to obey God, and when they did, they were defeated by the enemy. Their defeat was gradual, and it started with compromise. God told them not to intermarry with people from the pagan nations, just like He's told us not to marry someone who's an unbeliever. God's way is for His children to build godly families. But the Israelites found reasons to intermarry, and before long they were worshiping the gods of their unbelieving spouse. How does God respond to His people when they choose not to obey Him? In Judges 3, it tells us the Lord turns them over to their enemies. But I love verse 9, which says, "When the people of Israel cried out to the Lord for help, the Lord raised up a rescuer to save them." That statement is repeated in verse 15, and this tells us a lot about God and His desire to have a relationship with us. Whenever we decide we don't want to live in the enemy's territory and choose to turn away from disobeying God, we only need cry out to Him for help. He has raised up Jesus to be our rescuer, and Jesus died to defeat the power of the enemy in our lives. When we place our trust in Jesus, He will rescue us. Let's pray. Father, I want to thank you that the stories of your people in the Old Testament help us see ourselves better, and they give us pictures of how you work in our lives. Help us recognize when we've chosen to live according to the world's ways. Thank you so much for sending Jesus to be our rescuer and to help us overcome the enemy in our own lives. Amen.